Pre-show music, this is the pre-show music. Pre-show music playing strong. Pre-show music playing long. This is the pre-show music. So you can relax and have a good time while you wait for pictures to appear. Pre-show music, it's the best thing in the world. Pre-show music, tell me what rhymes with world.
Oh crap, what is this?
Pre-show, pre-show, pre-show music, pre-show music here. Everybody sing! Everybody sing. Pre-show music, this is the pre-show music. Pre-show music playing strong. Pre-show music playing long. This is the pre-show music, so you can relax and have a good time while you wait for pictures to appear. Pre-show music, it's the best thing in the world. Pre-show music, tell me what rhymes with world. Pre-show, pre-show, pre-show music, pre-show music here. Hey, hey. Hey. All right. Well, here we go. This is this. There's a, you know, if you're just randomly stumbling upon this, there is a an unusual origin to this live stream, which I'm calling my Get Good live stream. Well, specifically, I guess Dark Souls 2 Get Good live stream. This is a live stream I'm doing because my fundraising for the Christian Geek Central event GameSave 21, raising funds for St. Jude Children's Research Hospital, my fundraising reached its maximum, or my goal. I reached my goal. I actually went over $100 over my goal, which is $500, and I raised $600 that I last checked. And because I reached that by a certain date, I agreed to do this Get Good live stream, and this is a pretty significant cost. I mean, at the end of the day, not really. It would, a more significant cost would be to actually play this by myself without streaming. Streaming, it's like, okay, I get a chance to kind of connect with anybody that shows up and just make content and stuff, and that's all well and good. But I hate difficult video games. I always have. Going all the way back to the original Super Mario Brothers. I just have always found it, especially as a kid, way too discouraging to die or insta-fail for some other reason and have to repeat material again and again and again and again. I just find it way too frustrating. I think that as I have analyzed myself over the years, I can connect it to, I mean, certainly character flaws of mine. one of them being the tendency that I have always had, that a lot of people have, but I certainly have, to attach their sense of worth, their sense of self-worth to performance, to how good they are at things, to how much praise and affirmation they get from other people, or other people noticing how good they are at things, or even just by myself. Even if I was completely by myself as a kid playing Super Mario Brothers, it was a blow that I couldn't properly analyze for what it was. It was a blow to my sense of self-worth to fail again and again at Super Mario Brothers. And so, hi DT, I thought you weren't going to be able to make it out. This is like super late for you. So you probably won't be able to stay long, but thanks for coming. I did, if you didn't notice, I did speed read your tips for playing Dark Souls 2 before getting on here. But anyway, yeah, so this is not my idea of a good time. And I, you know, I'm 43 now, so I hopefully I've grown some in the area of where I'm getting my sense of identity and self-worth. But it's still a challenge, you know, and that's still a tendency of mine. And so I still find experiences like this extremely frustrating and off-putting. I play video games for a power fantasy and for just a sense of being transported to another world, to explore and see what's going on in other worlds. And I really do like dark aesthetics in video games, like these Souls games, starting with Demon Souls, Dark Souls, Bloodborne. I love the aesthetics that I see in those games. I would love to see a movie in that world, or I would love to play a game in that world that didn't also have brutal difficulty attached to it. Like the Castlevania Symphony of the Night type games, that's totally my jam because I get to be in that weird, dark, gothic world, but without the really punishing difficulty, you know? And I have mourned a bit seeing so many games that are inspired by Souls-likes come into being. And always, it's like so predictable now. If a game comes out and it has that dark, brutal, gothic, fantasy aesthetic, it's also going to mechanically be difficult and modeled after these types of games. And I just hate that. I just hate that because I love those kinds of worlds. And so one thing going for me in this stream is that I like that aesthetic because I think there's a part of me that does still care, that would really like to be able to play through games like this so that I can enjoy the world and the aesthetics, you know? If this were some, I don't know, sports game or some other kind of setting that I just didn't care about, then it wouldn't dig into me that that I'm unable to progress. But this game and like Bloodborne, it'll dig into me a little bit because I'll want to progress through this kind of world. I want to see as much of it as I can and the weird monsters and all that kind of stuff. And so I'm going to feel the frustration, I imagine, of not being able to do that. let's see. DT says, I'm so glad it is Dark Souls 2. Yes, this was voted on by patrons over at patreon.com/spiritbladeproductions. It was the choice between Bloodborne and Dark Souls 2. And I was really like, flip a coin, you know, I could go either way. I bought this one really cheap years ago, less than $5. I think it's actually disliked by a number of true blue, like top of the echelon Souls players. Those who would find the phrase get good to come very naturally to them. So I found it really cheap. Bloodborne I had access to because I currently have PlayStation Plus. But I bought it just for the purpose, basically, of maybe a streaming gimmick. And I played a little bit of it once before, years ago, but really didn't take it seriously. Really was just kind of not giving myself over to really, truly trying. And that's what I want to do. That's what I want to do tonight. DT goes on to say, Bloodborne is designed for people who already know Dark Souls and to surprise, like removing shields, for example. It is late, but I'm one of those sick and twisted. Yeah, meaning the sick and twisted people that want to see me putting myself through this. Well, I'm so glad that that you'll hopefully get something out of this. So, yeah, I have more things to say about me and this genre and this stream and stuff. But let's get into this. So I did delete the save that I had made years ago on this. I wanted to start fresh with this stream. Let's see here. Is that camera in a good enough place? I can scoot it over maybe just a wee little bit. That might be a little bit better. And let me know if I can adjust my audio levels for you. Oops, no. No? Oh, wait, well, it doesn't matter. I'm not playing online. Whatever. That's fine. Yep, that's good. All right, new game. Hello, Mark Five. He says, I enjoy Gothic-style games as well. The atmosphere evokes a sense of mystery and even religion. Yeah, that's true. Usually they're pulling from Catholicism or something. Even if it's in a fantasy world, you kind of get those vibes. See, this is totally my bag. I want to watch this movie right here. Big time. It's like Robert E. Howard, almost kind of like...
A place where souls may mend your ailing.
Solomon Kane. Dark sword and sorcery fantasy.
You will lose everything.
Yep, that's for sure.
Branded the symbol of the curse.
I haven't played the first one, so I have no idea if this should make any sense to me at all.
Darkness. Your past, your future, your very light. None will have meaning, and you won't even care. By then, you'll be something other than human. A thing that feeds on souls. A hollow. Long ago, in a walled-off land far to the north, a great king built a great kingdom. I believe they called
it
Drang Lake.
That looks so cool.
Perhaps you're familiar. No, how could you be? But one day, you will stand before its decrepit gate without really knowing why.
Boy, they're really pushing me into her face. Yeah, I want the Netflix series of Dark Souls, man. That's what I want. Not The Witcher with all of its naked people. I don't think these games are known for their naked people, right? I'm going to assume that I don't need to understand a lot of this, you know, because I've heard that these games also kind of pull a little bit from H.P. Lovecraft in that they are, it's about fear of the unknown
like
and fear of the mysterious.
A flame. Your wings will burn in anguish. Time after time. Is your fate the fate of the cursed?
One game that has a dark fantasy aesthetic that, you know, doesn't have brutal difficulty that I do enjoy is Path of Exile. I was just getting a little reminder of the world of Path of Exile. Specifically, you know, it's really, in addition to its gothic dark fantasy sensibilities, it's fairly muted color palette, you know, as Diablo 3 really kind of brightened things up a bit. To the light, right? It's probably, okay. I should probably, set precedent a little bit right at the start here. I had originally thought, you know, when conceptualizing this stream, it's like, do I want to put, you know, make a point of saying, you know, no help, no tips, nothing like that, you know, because that's a very, I think it's a very easy reflex action for people watching streams, you know, if they see somebody struggling to put tips in there and stuff. And some people, when they're streaming, like, I don't want that, you know. And part of me, I originally thought, you know, yeah, maybe I should take that approach because this is about me getting good, not, you know, getting tips and looking up walkthroughs and strategies and stuff like that. But I don't know. I mean, like, the whole get good thing, it's not It's not exactly like an organized religion or anything, but there does seem to be an underlying philosophy that I suspect is inconsistent quite a bit among proponents of get good. That I'll bet a lot of get gooders, they may feel like they're sounding cool and like an awesome gamer when they very unhelpfully, when someone asks for help in a forum, simply reply, get good. You know, they might think that, I'm awesome and I'm coming across as awesome. But I'm thinking a lot of those same folks watch plenty of tips videos, look up plenty of things that they're struggling with and stuff. And so I don't think that I don't believe that it is actually part of the get good philosophy to make all of your get gooding attempts in a vacuum. So, all that to say, if you want to throw out some tips, some suggestions, sure, go ahead. Also, if you want to try and get my attention in the chat, you have a better chance of that happening if you put at Christian Geek Central, no spaces, and spelling counts. It'll only work if it's all spelled correctly, at Christian Geek Central. And then for me, it'll be highlighted in orange, and so my peripheral vision will be more likely to pick up on it. But anyway, yeah, so here we go. I'm going to go toward the light. I'm going to turn down my headphones volume just a little bit. And I think that, you know, a number of games weirdly have, they kind of expect you to figure things out by going online and connecting with other players and sharing, comparing notes and stuff. I think games like Minecraft almost kind of pioneered that type of design where the developers kind of assume that you're going to be doing that kind of thing. No Man's Sky, Monster Hunter World, games with deep systems that are a bit obscured from the player.
What seems to be the ruckus?
Oh my, your face. The face of the curse. It's an undead. An undead has come to play. They all end up here. All the ones like you. You spoke to that kind old dear, didn't you?
They keep saying hmm, but the text clearly says heh. I'd like to hear some heh, please.
Finished. You'll go hollow. Yes. You will become one of them. Hollows prey upon men, feast upon their souls. This is the fate of the cursed.
They're all humming.
What is your name?
Pater. Let's see here. I'll tell them, but I don't think they're going to try and say it. People kind of get intimidated trying to figure out how to say my name. At a glance, it looks straightforward, but I think people psych themselves out. Yeah, I'm sure.
At least you know your own name. Here's your reward for sharing.
Aww.
It's a human effigy. Take a closer look. Think it's supposed to be. Think back deep into your past. Yes, it's an effigy of you.
Aww, she's really sweet. Oh, I gotta do, like, that guy actually, I mean, the hair color is already, I mean, the body type doesn't work at all for me. can I make myself a little flabby? Let's see if, let's see. Oh, I can. Let's see. But see, even like, I can't, well, I can make myself heavier or a little bulkier, but I can't make myself actually flabby. That's what I'd like to do. Yeah, because I don't have any of that kind of muscle. All right, I'll just go with the generic whatever. Oh, wait, physique, does that... No, that's still... I'm flabby. Oh, well. Okay. I'm not going to spend a lot of time here. I feel like that's just delaying the inevitable. So... oh, class and gift. Class. Oh boy. High strength, dexterity. I mean, like, see, I'm super tempted to go with a sorcerer because there are so few RPGs, and they tell me this is an RPG. Now, or an action RPG. I submit to you that these are, you know, really just games like this, and even ones that don't have this difficulty, are action games with RPG elements. If it's an RPG, a role-playing game, the emphasis should be on me playing the role, not on being good with twitchy skills and memorizing enemy patterns. But man, I love being like dedicated magic users in RPGs whenever I can, but I feel like I'm just setting myself up for like an impossible task. I feel like I just need to go with whatever sounds like it's gonna be the most resistant to damage. And that makes me sad. I wonder if there's a relationship, if these are like, they get progressively more difficult the further down you go. Battle scarred warrior, high strength, high dexterity, skilled weapons. I mean, I feel like this is the one I gotta go with. So, I'm sad about that, but whatever. Gift. Say DT has said some stuff here. Get good, I think, is actually satirical mocking those who just say get good without being helpful. I don't know anyone who beat the game without looking for help. And then also said sorcerer and magic will take a bit more learning. I recommend a knight. Okay, is that what I chose? Like, I think I chose a warrior. Let me... High HP and adaptability. Tough to take down. Oh, okay. Well, yeah. I should have read the helpful text. But he's not depicted with a shield. That's what has me kind of wondering. But you know what? I'll take your recommendation. I'll go with knight. I want to set myself up with as much opportunity to succeed here. Let's see. This is... What did we say this was? Oh, gift. This ring of old slot increases HP. Returns the hollowed to life. Didn't she already give me one of those? Unless it's a consumable or something? I don't know. I mean, it sounds like I would want that. Various items used to cure poison and restore HP. Essential for anyone traveling Drang-like. Returns you the bonfire last rested at. Having one may ease your mind, but there are no easy journeys. Eh. Seed grown from a tree of giants. Inedible. Toss into a bonfire to raise the strength of nearby foes. Only for those who seek greater challenges. Okay. Gosh. I don't know. I mean, these are probably all consumable, right? This is the only one that seems like it might not be. I think I am gonna go with the life ring. Alright. Well, it's close enough to my true self. My true self is safe here at home. And very glad for that.
All people come here for the same reason. To break the curse.
You're no different, I should think. Doesn't stand a chance.
Well, you never know.
Okay, she had ha ha. Or ha ha ha. Some of them arguably has.
Go through the door and trot along to the kingdom.
But remember, hold on to your souls. They're all that keep you from going hollow. Oh, I'll fool you no longer. You'll lose your souls. All of them. Over and over again.
Yep. That's kind of what I'm bracing for. Nice, DT. Says, will this stream be 3.5 hours selecting character and 30 minutes playing? Joke, of course. Take your time. Yeah, I might be tempted to that kind of activity when it comes to my jump scare live stream later on this year, even if it's just the 2-hour one. Okay. So I did still get some life gems. I remember those from last time when I played this. Okay.
This is a limbo. A link between Drangleic and the outer world. Fair traveler.
Oh, crap! Okay, well, now I know how to activate the life gem.
This lost, decayed kingdom.
I kept wasting my life gems over and over again. What are you doing? Are you switching weapons? Oh, we're going two-handed. Okay. Okay. All right, so R buttons, light attack, and right trigger's heavy. I think the first time I played this, that in itself was way off-putting, but I've played some games since then that have put attack up on, like, the bumper and trigger, so I might be a little better positioned for that now. Oh, that takes me outside. I was hoping I might find, like, some items or something in here. Anything that will help. I think these ladies here have probably been as helpful as they're going to be. No, ma'am, that is ha ha ha. Yeah, bust up some pots, maybe. Oh! Human effigy. Oh, okay, so I got one anyway. Great. Okay. No. Here? Anything? No? Okay. Wait, there's a door here too, though. Is this the way I came in? No, this doesn't look familiar. What is this? Bonfires are places of respite. You may also light torches on them. Okay. Light a bonfire. Okay. Rest at bonfire, sure. Sure. Is this where I praise the sun or whatever? I've heard about that. Attune spells. Burn. Burn. Huh. Reverse hollowing. It also weakens the links to other worlds, preventing invasions and most cooperation. Peer closely at an effigy and one begins to perceive a human form, but whose form it takes depends on the person looking. Okay, flavor text, whatever. Tune spells. No spells, that's fine. That's probably complication I don't need. Item box. Wait, okay. gradually restores a small amount of HP. Okay. Lose soul and return. Dark sign. Dark sign induces death, returning the player to the last bonfire, rested at the cost of all souls held. Oh. Do what you must to gather the pieces, scraping them into some semblance of a whole before the will to do so fades. Okay. Symbol of farewells that has been passed down since time immemorial. The crystal sends phantoms back to their homes or sends you back to yours. Whether ending in hope or despair, encounters are blah blah blah. Oops, dang it. Come on. Pater, what are you... Alright. Oh, online play item. Not needed. Ported hood. Oh, let's see, what do we got here? Oh. Oh. Why would I not wear this? Oh. Because it's got... a stamp on it. I don't know. What do we got here? Worn by the Volgan Falconers. Domestic Volgan soldiers are infamously timid, so it is no wonder that this fierce band of mercenary falconers was hard to compensate. In practice, they serve as bodyguards for the Anthem. Blah, 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 blah. Whatever. How do I put it on? Oh, help. Yeah. No. Do this. Now help. Okay. It's not going to tell me how to wear it. Okay. That's fine. Oh, wait a minute. Is the red thing what I already have equipped? Is that what that means? I think so, because over here, I've got life gems equipped. Okay, so I already had the best thing equipped. All right, okay. So I don't know why I have these other things. Okay. Oh, yeah, what is this? This just raises my max HP. It's a static. Okay. Okay. Oh, thank you, DT. I saw your comment too late. Stamp means it is equipped. All right. DT says, you have not earned the right to talk about Praise the Sun. RIP Sol, RIP Solaire. Oh man, you got a good memory, DT. He says, hi, I remember that when I last streamed this. Corinne, why don't you waste another life gem, Pater? Okay, Corinne, no wait, Pater activates life gem. Yeah. Yeah, I was not really entering into a proper effort at that time. Okay, I think I got both of those. All right. Well, here we go, right? I don't think I can put it off any longer. Now, let's see here. Oh, bumper. Now, where's the easy difficulty setting? what I really want is just to see the button layout. Did I miss it? Did I just go right past it? Jump controls. Okay. I guess I need the instruction booklet if I want to see the map of the controls. Auto target on. That sounds like a good thing. All right. Screen options. That's fine. That's all fine. Okay. All right. Your Ivan Inspector says, I wish there was an easy mode. Yeah. You know, I understand from a pure... developer perspective, like limited resources and stuff like that, why why they wouldn't, you know, because you have to test all those different modes unless you want them to suck, you know. But if they have the resources for it, I do not understand why they wouldn't do that, apart from, actually, something that I think falls back on the get-gooders. And that is a lack of discipline on the part of the player. Now, you might say, whoa, 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 the get-gooders, they have all kinds of discipline. I think that there's a significant number of them that would not have the discipline to stay on the normal difficulty when they hit a wall. I think that's where their discipline would fail for many of them, that it would just be too much of a temptation, that there's something about they like having that choice taken away from them. And I don't want to totally poo-poo the get-good attitude. I think there's a sanctified version of it. I've discovered some of the enjoyment of the get-gooding with Monster Hunter World, which is not as brutal, but still requires a little bit of get-gooding. All right, now where's my... Okay, there's my dodge. Okay. Now, I feel like these little guys I need to practice on. Oh, they're fast little buggers. Okay, so I got that one. Oh. Oh, crap. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. It's already going badly. Oh, my gosh. They're, like, swarming me now. Maybe I shouldn't have done this. Oh. Man, it's hard to see these guys. Oh, they're fast little buggers. Ugh. I guess I shouldn't say that. You know, there's... I think in British circles, like... I think in America... Oh, life gem. Now's the time, right? Oh, my gosh. I need to... How do I run? Oh, my gosh. How do I run? Oh, no, I'm going the wrong way. I wanted to run back to the ladies. Okay, where... Okay, nope, that's not the right one. Oh, wait, was that a run? Oh, I was running. Okay, so, pro tip, everybody. Hold down B to run. Okay. Yeah, but I think, like, for British people... Bugger is like, that's like a crass sexual slur, maybe. But that's not how I mean it. I mean it the American version. It's just like stinker. All right, so let's do life gem. Okay, all right. Oops, dang it. Nope, ah, crap. I gotta get used to like my distance there. Oh, nice, okay. What was that? Okay. All right. And I get nothing from them. Wait. Wait. Can anybody guess what I'm looking for? What particular stat I want to see? They're using symbols. They're using symbols. I'm thinking that arrow up, 948. I'm hoping that represents XP. That's what I want to be able to fall back on at the end of the day. And I've heard that, like, in... Maybe not in Bloodborne, or is it Neo that you can't... I don't know. It's through pop culture osmosis and just kind of, like, watching reviews and listening to, you know, gaming podcasts and stuff. I do gain some familiarity with games that I have no interest in playing. And I believe that in the Dark Souls games, you can grind for XP. Like, if you really just want to do that, you know, and get through the game that way, that theoretically you can. It just takes freaking forever. But back in the day, that's what I would totally spend hours just grinding these little monkey people. Oh. All right, let's see here. DT says, make sure to go into the menu and actually put on the ring. Oh, okay. Yeah, that's a good tip. Let's see here. Yeah, where was that? This is what I'm currently wearing. So, oh, okay. Is that the ring? No, that's Dark Sign. Oh, here we go. Alright. Confirm. What? How about equip? How about equip? What the crap? Did I have to do that at the freaking bonfire? Okay. Alright. At least that doesn't feel like, I mean, if that is the case, we'll find out in a moment here. Or I'll find out while you all just agonizingly wait for me to find things out. But at least it doesn't seem to be a mechanic that is predicated on the idea of realism. Wait. No, that's Dark Sign. Oh, can I? Let's see. What? What? Look for the slot with a picture ring on it. Yeah, okay. XP equals the souls you have, bottom right. Okay, I'll keep an eye out for that. Not seeing how to equip this. Sort? Nope. See, what is leave? What's the difference between leave and discard? Leave. Leave life ring. No, I don't want to leave it. Oh, jeez. What the crap? I would have so no patience for this game. I would have been out. I would have been out already. Really? You're not even going to show me the map of the controls? All right, I'm going to go out of adventuring without equipping the life ring, because I can't figure that out. So if you want to put a tip in the chat for me, let me look one more time in my... actually, let me go back to this one. Oh, wait. There's an empty slot for a ring. Let's try this. Oh! There we go. Okay. All right, so where was that bottom right, you said? Player status, bottom right. Oh, 180. So the little, like, circular thing. Okay, 180. All right. Okay. All right. Yeah, sorry, there's a bit of a delay, and so I think I figured it out, but thank you, DT, for the tips there. Now, do these guys... Oh, here's what I want to know. Here's what I want to know. Okay, let's run. Let's make it just a little less agonizing for those watching, Pater. Oh, crap! Stamina! You need stamina to run! Ugh. Freaking laborious. I mean, yeah, okay, we're gonna rest. Okay, now we're gonna go back. I think maybe that might respawn enemies for me. The right path to go is near the bonfire thing. Thanks, DT. Mark Fye says, LB to the menu with the sword, then choose the ring slot. Yeah, okay, cool. Thank you both for your tips there. Are they here? Yes, I hear them shuffling. Okay. Oh, dang it. Misjudged that again. Oh, crap. Ah, crap. Oh, my gosh. Come on, dude. Ugh. Oh, you know what? Hang on. Be smart, Pater. Be smart. Yeah, right here. One at a time, baby. Do they get all their health back? That's the question. Do they get... Oh, crap. No, I don't think he did. I don't know. This method might not help me like I'm hoping it will. Oh, jeez. Okay, I am gaining XP, though, so that's good. That's good. What is that that's refilling? Is that, like, my stamina? Let's do another life gem. Just wait for that to fill up for a second here. Now, let's see here. What does that mean? Is that... Oh, so... I was hitting X for life gem, but which was mystifying to me. It was like, that looks like they're showing me what's mapped to my cross pad. But it probably is mapped to both X and cross pad, which is weird. I don't want it mapped to X. All right. Oh man, missed. There we go. Okay, so those guys are worth 30 each. Are there any more shuffling? I think I might have killed them all. Now, here's a question. I'm probably going to frustrate you guys. Because if I'm really like... If conceptually this stream is about me really genuinely trying my best to make my way through this game, because my skills are so crappy, I'm gonna lean on systems wherever I can. Yeah, it gives me my health back. Oh, you guys are gonna hate this stream now. Oh. All right, listen. Listen, you guys did not come here to watch me fight monkeys and run back and forth between monkeys and a bonfire all night. So I'm not gonna do that. But if I were legit, like, as a kid, playing this game, and like, you know, as a kid, you've got really limited finances, maybe a very meager allowance. Unless your parents are spoiling the crap out of you. So it's like you got birthday, you got Christmas. You're gonna get one big ticket item, both of those, right? And maybe the rest of the year you save up for one game. You know, in my house, that's how it was. I was raised by two public school teachers, and public school teachers don't get paid great. So it was like maybe one or two new games a year for me. And so you save up. Or you ask for the big ticket item. And back in the day, you know, reviews were not near as plentiful. You couldn't learn near as much about a game before you got it. So if I was a kid, I got stuck with this game. Like, I got it, I was like, oh! And then I realized, oh no, I suck. Then that's what I would do. I would say, this is my game. This is the game that I have now. And I have no other games except for this one. I'm going to extract the fun out of it. That's what I would do. I would be... Weeks on end, fighting monkeys. Back to the bonfire, fighting monkeys, back to the bonfire. I understand you guys don't want to see that, so I'm not going to do that. Let's see here. DT says also you won't be able to attack if you keep your pause menu open. Those symbols on the top left. Oh, yeah, yeah. That's a good tip. I don't want to get stuck in a menu. And Mark 5 says those monkey-like creatures won't attack you unless you attack them. I did wonder that at one point, but thank you for confirming that. Hello, Kubabooba. Thanks for coming out. As a reminder, if you want a better chance of getting my attention, at Christian Geek Central, all spelled correctly, no spaces, will highlight your comment in orange so I'm more likely to spot it in my peripheral. Kubabooba says, you should have played as a wizard. You can fire energy bolts or whatever from afar and cheese the enemies. That's how I beat these games, LOL. Dang it! Dang it, Kubabooba. Where were you during my character generation? I just assumed that, that it was going to be, like, way more difficult to play as, like, a glass cannon-type character. Crap. Oh, well. DT says, you can grind later. It would be better if you got a shield first and went to the main bonfire where you can level up, but you need to go to the bonfire path to start the game. Okay. All right. To start the game. Like, Peter, you haven't started the game. You need to start the game. This is not playing the game. All right, so I'm going to bypass these guys for now and look for this main bonfire. Okay? So, let's see here. What is this? This is useless. Gestures. I was kind of hoping for a map. No, Peter. Don't you know? This game isn't about fun. Crap, okay. All right, I gotta test this. Yep, dang it. All right. Now I know. Knowing's half the battle. Yo, Joe. And then this is, you know, where the game rubs your face in it. By first off giving you a big you died and then a big long load screen. They couldn't give me the you died while they're reloading my game, at least. All right. All right. Now I'm like hollow, right? That's what the zombie face means? Oh, and I lost all my XP. Oh, crap. Okay. Hi. I think I have an item that makes me not hollow or something, right? Or am I supposed to, like, go to where I died and get my souls? Are souls... is that their name for XP in this game? Souls? I'm gonna go to that drop-off point and just hope that my XP is waiting there for me. At the edge. Was that the edge I went off of? Ah, crap. Wait. There's something glowy over here. Oh! Touch my bloodstain! Yes! Okay. So 360, but I still look like a zombie. Alright, well, I feel like I'm probably at a disadvantage now in this zombie form, but... there's a door that leads out of the room with the old women, which proceeds to the next area. So, I don't know if I went out that proper door or not. I feel like this is the wrong way. I feel like this is going backwards. Like, this is the starting area, and I'm supposed to progress in some way. Now, years ago when I played this, the first significant enemy I found, I just could not get past. I mean, I wasn't really giving it a good try, but I also heard, and I think this is where you go to run into that. Oh, no, no. No, he's off to the left here, I think. Oh, jeez! Yeah, I think he's over that log or something. And somebody told me later, I think it was somebody in the comments said, you're not even supposed to try and fight that guy. Oh, this is the way to him. Yeah. That's the guy that you're not supposed to fight, apparently. So, we're going to cross here, and we're going to go... I don't know, could this be where I need to go? Climb, jump. Nope. Trying different buttons here, and they're not doing things. Okay, I'm gonna go back in here. Oh, so, well, this led to the bonfire, right? But I don't think there was another way out. Okay. Oh, wait, what's this? Oh! Okay. Okay. Into the mist. Okay. Oh! Here's the tutorial place. Crap. Oh. Zombies. Let's see how this goes. Oh! Well, that was way easier than even the monkeys. That was way easier than the monkeys. Target lock, release. Man, okay. I didn't even get to the tutorial last time. Target lock, release. While target locked, change target. Okay. Oh. Okay. Oh, man. I think I'm already auto-target locking, because my right stick didn't... My R3 button didn't seem to do anything with targeting. Oh, yeah, I already learned this. Okay. Man. Oh, I hear you. Oh, okay, just... Okay, so I could theoretically just kind of like... I didn't have to dodge away from them. I kind of wanted to test that. Okay. So, okay. Oh, I hear somebody growling. Oh. I guess I don't have any kind of history. Player info? What I want to know, I want to remind myself what it means that I'm hollow, why it's not good that I'm hollow right now. Isn't that what I am? I'm hollow or something? I don't know. I hear you. There you are. Oh, that's right. Pause menu. Okay. See, that's the dude down there. That's the dude that I fought before. I don't know if it's exactly the same dude, but it was one of those things. Alright, don't fall off the edge. Behind enemy's back, critical hit. Oh, okay, alright. Yeah, DT, he says, remember, lock on is the most important tool. I tried to lock on. I used the instructions they provided to activate lock on, and... It didn't seem to do anything. So, I mean, I'll try again with another zombie, I guess. What are these things? I feel like I should be lighting them or something, but... Ooh. What's that? Dagger. Well, that's not better, is it? Let's see. Can I put a dagger in my offhand? Dagger in the offhand! Oh, wait a minute. Should I put it in my... Let's see here. Oh, no, it's not. Okay, first, I was trying to read the stats here and figure out what was actually better. Okay. Okay. Alright, well... Oh, there's another one. Okay, so let me try to lock onto this one. Oh, crap! Yeah, see that? My button is... Oh, crap! Get out of the... Oh, crap! Well, I gotta say, this is starting out a lot less ridiculous than it seemed to be last time. Like, I thought the experience I was having last time with the monkeys, that, like, that was everybody's experience. And, like, immediately being swarmed by these things that could kill me really fast. And now these things, they didn't even take that much out of my health. Could it be that I have just had the wrong impression of this game? For more chat about geek entertainment, answers to your questions, and news from the wider world of Christian geekery, get the Christian Geek Central podcast today on iTunes and other podcast services.